comrades and friends. Our entire people from north to south, closely united, have raised up to defend their freedom and independence, and at the same time contribute to the cause of the peoples struggling for their emancipation and peace. We are absolutely sure of our victory. We are strong with our entire people and with the growing support of the people of the world, including the U.S. people. We sincerely thank you. Long live the friendship between our peoples.
There's a time when the operation of the machine becomes so odious, makes you so sick at heart, that you can't take part. You can't even passively take part. And you've got to put your bodies upon the gears and upon the wheels, upon the levers, upon all the apparatus, and you've got to make it stop. And you've got to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all.
While we weep, and while we talk about mourning, and while we suffer with the Vietnamese for what has happened to them in these cities, we have to recognize that Hanoi Haiphong is not Hiroshima, is not Dresden, is not Nagasaki. The people fought back. They didn't flee in terror. They shot with rifles, they shot with machine guns, they shot with missiles, and they won. And we have to recognize what this means. B-52s are strategic aircraft that have been invincible. They have been invulnerable up until now. And this is a turning point in the air war. In a very real sense, Nixon's air war has been defeated. The B-52 as a strategic, invulnerable weapon has been defeated. 34 B-52s were shot down. This is why Nixon... This is why Nixon is now back at the negotiating tables. This is one of the reasons why. And he can no longer hold over the heads of the Vietnamese, if you don't bow to our demands, we will bomb your cities with B-52s. Because according to the visitors who were there during the bombing, what happened in the streets? Yes, the people were being bombed, but they continued laughing, they continued singing, they continued treating their American guests with humanity and hospitality, they continued to go about their work, and Christmas Day, they evacuated in a good scientific fashion 400,000 people in 24 hours from Hanoi. Imagine trying to do that from this country, from any city in this country. It speaks well for socialism.
Let me say that the bombing is inhumane beyond description. It's killing little babies and women and old men. And beyond being inhumane beyond description, it is stupid. And they are only more determined than ever. I think they're kind of like I am in that regard, maybe even like you. I get mad when people kick me around, and I'm slow to get mad. But you start bombing them and killing them, and you don't leave them a lot of choice, I think. The issue arose anyway. They said, we distinguish between the American people and the war leaders. The mayor of Haiphong, for instance, and it just amazed me, he said, please extend my deepest gratitude and the deepest gratitude of the people of this city to those in America who seek peace, because we seek peace, but we will fight till he had independence and freedom.
Nixon is going to say that the agreements will be signed and that the war will end because the other side was brought to their knees. It was an American victory. And we, as political people, have to be sure that we don't ever stop until the people in this country understand that it's been an American defeat, hard as it is for Americans to accept. A third world underdeveloped country with no industry, 90% of whose people are peasants, has defeated the mightiest imperialist power in the world. And so our struggle must continue. And if our struggle is to continue, we have to support the people who are the victims of repression, and it's going to get worse. I'm old, and I lived through the McCarthy era, and my family was called up in front of HUAC, and a lot of people were silenced during that period, and I remember what it meant, and Nixon ushered that period in, and he's trying to do the same thing today. He's trying to stop the movement. He's going to try to do it with repression, political repression. He's going to try to sever us off from everything that happened in the 60s, just the way they did it in the 50s. Everything that happened before, the labor movement, everything that happened was stopped. So the kids of the 60s had to start all over again. We can't allow it to happen. But we have to fight him.
Oh, Ho Chi Minh, oh, Ho Chi Minh. Saigon mean to you?
Oh, it's heavenly. It's just, I mean, I've been waiting for it for most of my adult life.
Well, I think the surrender of Saigon is probably the most important thing that has happened in the last 50 years in the world.
Bring the war home! Bring the war home! Bring the victory home! Bring the victory home!
Are you from Vietnam?
Yeah, I am.
How do you feel about the surrender of Saigon?
Very happy, very happy. There'll be peace in Vietnam, and there's peace right now. We look at this as the victories, the great victories of the Vietnamese people. And this is also the great victories of the American people who have side by side with us a struggle for the peace and independence in Vietnam.
The spirit of Vietnam is stronger than the U.S. bomb.